Hey guys, it's iDavis from the Czech community, and in this official Elvenar video tutorial, we are going to take a look at roadmap features, the efficient ways you can progress there, and the benefits that progressing on the roadmap brings to your city. So take a seat and subscribe to our channel so that you always keep it up with latest news from Elvenar. Let's take it to the roadmap using the globe button in the bottom navigation bar. On the world map, you can explore your neighbors that are located around your city, scout provinces, and fight and negotiate encounters. At the beginning, most of the world is unknown to you, so it appears to be hidden behind a sand yellow color, and you can discover new areas by scouting the provinces that are located around your city. You can do this by sending your scouts to any province that touches the area that you have already discovered, and pay some amount of coins to start the scouting process. You need to wait some time until your scouts return, and then you can start scouting another province, so keep in mind that you can only be scouting one province at a time. Once the scouting process is finished, you can start completing the province. In order to complete a province, you need to solve all the encounters that are inside. You always have two options to solve an encounter, so you can choose whether you want to go with fighting or negotiating. The enemies that appear, as well as the required goods, depend on what type of province it is. Let's take a marble province as an example. You will more likely need to pay marble and the goods that are being positioned in the same order in each category as the marble is. So in this case, besides marble, you will also need a lot of crystals and elixirs, as these are the first in each category as well. This rule is not necessarily followed in every encounter in the province, but it is the most likely combination you will see. Before you get into solving any province, I recommend you to always check the difficulty indicator, which shows how difficult the fighting in the specific province will be. If you feel like the difficulty is too high, you can rather look for another, easier province to solve, and I would also recommend you to scout those easier provinces first. Or you can increase your squad size by researching the squad size upgrade technologies in the research tree. These make the provinces easier. Here, keep in mind that each difficulty level covers a wider range of actual difficulties in the battlefield, so in some cases, you might need to research more of these technologies until the difficulty level drops down. Easier provinces have also lower costs and lower scouting times, so beginning with these will allow you to scout more provinces overall. Also, in the beginning of most chapters, you can find a technology called Advanced Scouts, which reduces the scouting cost as well as the time needed to finish scouting. Always keep advancing on the world map and keep scouting in your provinces, as this is not only a relic source for you, but you also need to have a certain number of provinces completed in order to enter a new chapter. In the research tree, we can see that each chapter has a preset number of provinces that you need to have completed to begin the specific chapter. These numbers may also give you a hint about the number of provinces you should have completed in your current stage of the game. Following these numbers will not only prevent you from getting stuck in the research tree for having an insufficient number of provinces to unlock the next chapter, but will also result in your open provinces on the world map having relative and adequate costs to your current chapter. That's especially important to follow from the opposite direction, do not exceed the numbers too much, and that's where we dive into something called overscouting. Overscouting happens if you are going scouting and completing your provinces too hard, more than the numbers in the research actually require from you. This might often result in world map provinces costs getting too high compared with what you can afford at your current stage of the game. The province difficulties, as well as the costs for negotiating, are constantly growing the further you go, so at some point, it might be better for you to rather take a pause, wait some time, research some technologies in the meantime, for example those that are increasing your squad size, so those that are making the battles easier, and then return back and continue making progress. Apart from the increasing numbers of costs you are facing, a new resource can also appear at some point as you progress on the world map. This is currently the case with orcs, which you can produce only from chapter 8, orcs and goblins, and if you are rushing provinces during earlier chapters it can happen that you will run into a province asking for orcs before you can actually produce them. You can produce orcs in armories at level 20+, which is unlocked in the Orcs and Goblins chapter. That means you can get stuck at this point in the world map and it might bring you other issues. For example, once you get an event quest asking for completing a province or solving encounters that you cannot do by negotiating, so you can only fight and end up either losing a huge number of units or the whole battle at all if the difficulty is too high. So to underline the ideal approach to scouting provinces, once you follow the numbers in the research tree, you can make sure that the difficulty will always keep close to how much you can pay and what resources are available to you at the moment. As discovering new areas on the world map is supposed to be one of the main features in Elvenar, it obviously not only allows you to unlock new chapters, but also brings several other benefits for you. They are a good source for city expansions. For every few provinces you complete, you get a free expansion, which you can find in the expansion tab of the buildings window and which provides additional space for your city. You can always hover over the province expansion box to see how many more provinces you need to complete until you receive another province expansion again. Many features and productions in the game are also calculated by the number of completed provinces. For example, Orcs production in the Heroes Forge Ancient Wanderer is actually a multiple of the number of completed provinces, and so is the mana production of the Maze of the Dark Matter Ancient Wanderer. Also some other buildings, like some of the evolving buildings obtained in events, often work in a way to have their production or special effect depending on this number and many more, so keeping this number growing also means increasing your productions here and there. At the end of the day, completing provinces also opens up your gates for better performance in tournaments. In tournaments, you always fight in provinces you already have completed. The number of provinces you get unlocked in a specific tournament type depends on how many provinces of a certain type you have completed. So, if you know you can play well in some specific type of tournament, you can prepare such provinces in advance. And with that being said, that's what I've got for this tutorial, so thank you for watching. Don't forget to join us by subscribing, and I will see you next time.